Hi, this is Rob. I'm going to show you how to do a future value with compounding on the TI-84 Plus CE graphing calculator. Future value is a time value of money problem, or TVM problem, and to solve TVM problems on the TI-84 Plus CE, we'll use the built-in finance app in the calculator. To get started, press the apps key located here. The application window pops up, and we want the finance app here at the top by the number 1. Hit the 1 key or the Enter key to access the Finance app. Here we want the first one, TVM Solver, Time Value of Money Solver. Press the 1 key or the Enter key. These are all the time value of money variables. I will explain each one. N at the top is the number of payment periods over the entire time frame. If the time frame is 2 years, then N would be the number of payment periods over those 2 years. I% is the annual interest rate, also known as APR. Do not convert this into a decimal format. If the annual interest rate is 1.01%, then enter as 1.01. PV is present value. This app uses the cash flow method. Thus, if money is leaving your pocket to fund an account, then enter the money leaving your pocket as a negative number. Remember to use the negative sign and not the minus key when inputting this value. If you use the minus key, you will get an error message. PMT, payment, is for the amount of regular payments being added or withdrawn into or out of the account. For example, if every month you take $100 out of your pocket to fund the account, then enter a negative 100 here. FV is for future value. This is the variable that we'll be solving. PPY is payments per year and is closely related to the next one, CPY. Compoundings per year. If the interest is compounded daily, then enter 365 for both PPY and CPY. If interest is compounded monthly, then enter 12 for both PPY and CPY. The last one, PMT N begin, is when the payment is made at the end of the period or at the beginning of the period. Leave this at N, unless you have a problem that states that the payments are made at the beginning of each period. Let's take a look at a future value problem. You put $1,000 into a bank 1-year certificate of deposit, CD, that has an interest rate of 1.1% per year. That is an APR of 1.1% and is compounded daily. After 1 year, how much money do you have? Assume 1 year equals 365 days. For N, number of periods, we have a total time frame of 1 year, and the compoundings is 365 within that 1 year. Thus enter 1 for 1 year times 365 for the compoundings per year. Thus N will equal 365 for this problem. For I%, the annual interest rate, or APR, is 1.1%, so enter 1.1. Remember, do not convert this percentage into a decimal number. Just enter 1.1. For PV, present value, we take $1,000 out of our pocket to fund this CD. Thus, enter a negative 1,000. Remember, use the negative key here to enter a negative 1,000. Do not use the minus key. If you use the minus key, this is the error message you will receive. Error, syntax. To go back to the Time Value of Money app, select number 2, go to, and change that minus sign to a negative sign. Negative because we are taking money out of our pocket to fund this account. PMT, payments. We are not making regular payments, so leave this at 0. FV, future value. This is what we are looking for, so leave this at 0. We'll be coming back to this variable. The next two variables, payments per year and compoundings per year, this is going to be the same for both, which is 365. Our compoundings is daily, thus 365. In fact, after you enter 365 for payments per year and go down to compoundings per year, the calculator will automatically fill in 365 for CPY. Leave the bottom one at end and move up to the variable that we are trying to solve, future value. Now to solve the problem, press this green alpha key and then the enter key. And there's our answer, After 1 year, we will have $1,011.06 in our bank CD. Do you see that little black square next to FV? That means that FV is the variable that we just calculated. Remember, to solve, we go up to the variable we are trying to solve for and press the green alpha key, then the enter key. If you mistakenly press the second key and then the enter key, this is what happens. You get some number times another number sometimes, or you get this other value here. If you get an answer that does not make sense, it is because you press the second key and the enter key. Make sure you press the green alpha key and then the enter key to solve these problems. Okay, that is it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to this channel.